and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Rachael Sadler and I am the owner of Ada's Attic Vintage. In today's video, I am going to be sharing with you everything that I know about running your own vintage shop, how I got started, and the tips and sort of the best things I've sort of learned along the way through a lot of practice. So if you didn't know now already, I have been running my own vintage shop now for 6 years. It's called Ada's Attic Vintage. It was named that mainly because, which is a bit of a weird story, when we were kids, me and my little sister would literally never get out of bed to go to school, so mum used to come up with all these like funny names, which is funny now that they're all like really trendy, and I love old names, hence the name Olive, my little beautiful dog, Olive. And she used to say, quick, the new cat Ada's downstairs and she wants you to come and feed her. So it just sort of came out like that. It literally was like half a second decision because I never thought I'd be actually lucky enough to own my own shop and make money from it and be successful. So that is why it's called Ada's Attic Vintage. My name isn't Ada, but I kind of wish it was, but you know. I started after me and my boyfriend Anthony came back from travelling. So we went travelling for a year and I had always wanted to have my own vintage shop. I actually wanted to call it Olive, which I remembered not that long ago. But obviously called it Ada's instead, and now we have a beautiful Olive anyway. And I started it whilst I was working full time. I had a very intense full time job, which I left in March. I gradually reduced my hours, and then in March I was like, you know what, it's enough now. It's now time for me to get out on my own and do what I class as a hobby, which I suppose would now be classed as like a side hustle, full time, and it was the best decision I've ever made, and I literally love every second of my life right now. So I feel very lucky and very grateful. So how I first started was, we went travelling for a year, came back, I went back to live with my mum in Nottingham, Anthony came back and lived with his parents here in Birmingham, and we literally had, or I had, no money at all. There was this charity shop down my mum's high street, which used to sell everything for £1, and I mean everything. So I've always looked in charity shops, car boots. Mum and dad used to have like their own business, used to do market stands. That was like one of my first memories of like getting up really early in the morning when it was cold, going to sleep in the back of the van, which you would not be allowed to do now, would you? and like going off to these markets. I was a painfully shy, and when I mean painfully, I mean painfully shy child. Literally would not say boo to a goose. At that time, my dad used to sell lampshades and these uplighter things. And then I had to go out after my dad had got all these massive crowd of people up and show all these people how to make this uplighter lampshade, and I can still do it now because I used to practice, because I used to hate doing it so much. I'd do it as quick as possible, then I'd run off and cry in the back somewhere, probably painfully shy. But then like me and mum would always go to like car boot sales, like charity shops, like anything that you could have a bit of a rummage. My super lovely granddad was a painter and decorator by trade, and he used to like mum and like obviously my granddad, my mum's dad, born and raised in Fulham, like before it was posh though, and he used to go around all these amazing houses and like get these cool things that they were like throwing out. I saw him a couple of weekends ago and he was like telling me about one of these like really fancy swish houses for like the managing director of Debenhams. Like I assume it's probably like in the 50s probably, when he went around to like decorate a room in his house, and he was putting this most amazing like wallpaper on the wall, and like he was slinging out something, and he said, oh, my granddad said, oh, can I have it? He went, yeah, help yourself, mate. And he, in his house now, he has the most amazing like gilt-edged mirror, and it's absolutely giant. It's like, it's probably like 6 foot long and like the same sort of height. It's amazing. And I remember this mirror all the time as being a kid. Even as a child, I used to walk in my granddad's house and just like stare at this mirror thinking, it's amazing. It's just, I don't know what about it as a kid. It just caught my imagination. And I just love it. And my granddad likes going to tips, all these cool things. So I really do think it was like ingrained in me from like a young age to like, I like to have a rummage and to like It's like almost like the thrill of the hunt is so exciting. I can't tell you how much I love going out to all these like cool like home clearance places, charity shops, jumble sales, car boots, and now I even get invited around people's houses, which just blows my mind because it's like literally heaven, as you can tell. I like to talk, especially about vintage, and get to go around and see all these beautiful clothes in these beautiful houses. I actually have to pinch myself because it is just so much fun. Literally, it is the best. So anyway, enough of me rambling. So I came back, I had literally no money. And when I say I mean no money, I mean like nada. So I had like £10, and then off I went down to this like £1 charity shop down on High Street and bought 10 things. And then came back, and then my mum's got like these white doors in her house with like the panelling on. Got her put on this like this one piece I remember in particular. It was like this sort of rainbow print zebra.
Yes.
Jacket. I really liked it. Now that's the rule that I've always had. I've only ever bought things that I like, and I do, and like quality over quantity. That is like the best thing, because quality will always sell because it's a quality item. So at the time, 6 years ago, this jacket, I was like, good Lord, this is like heaven in a jacket. Oh my God, it's amazing. So off I trotted back home with my other 9 items. I was like, mum, can you take a picture of me, please? Of course. So off I stood, and the picture, I wish I had it now because I'd love to show you, but I can't find it. Obviously I've deleted it. Was like from here down to like the top of my legs there, just so you could literally just see the jacket. And because the door has like this panelling thing, and it's all like slightly skew width, and it's like, it's such a shockingly bad photo, really. Like, you wouldn't want to put it anywhere. So that was one of the first things I bought. And then I still remember that now, at the moment now, walking back from work. At the time I was a waitress in a pub, and I was like, oh my God, I've sold it. And it was like the best feeling, and instantly from that moment I was hooked. So as the time went on, as the time goes on, you kind of like, you learn so much without even realizing. Like, you start to learn about all these like vintage designers, and I can walk into like a crowded warehouse filled with things and just see something. It could be like the edge of a dress or like corner of a seam, and I just know that that is a good item, and that is just from practice. Like, practice does make perfect in this game, I think. You will learn so much without even realizing, and you become a sponge, because I am so interested in everything to do with vintage. I just love it. I want to teach myself all these things. I've taught myself how to do everything. So I've originally started to sell on ASOS Marketplace. I no longer sell with them. I haven't sold them within a few years, because I thought personally that they, after like your fees, so I think it was like £20 a month for your rent to have your boutique on there. And then it was 20% commission, but then you always had to get paid via PayPal. So it was working out just under 25%. That's almost like a quarter of your like overall profit, like your sale already, and that's before you take off like the costs of your time and like how much you've actually paid for the item, and then if you sort of combine any sort of like shipping costs into the sort of overall cost of the item. So it was a real it's really expensive, I thought. So I left them, it must be like 3 years ago now, sell on my own website and Etsy. I've tried selling on eBay, Depop, literally any site. I think it's good to sort of give it a go, because it's never wasted time. Like, you always learn something. That's what I found anyway. So as time's gone on, I have just continued to sort of like grow my boutique. I add at least one new item every day. I now go all over. Like, my feet will literally not let me walk past some sort of like junk shop, I suppose some people would call it, without having a little look to see what I might be able to find. And I now get invited around to people's houses, which is amazing. And like, this has just been like the most amazing like hobby, because when I first started out, I was like, oh, it's just like a fun little hobby. Like, I would literally love it. I would love to do it. Like, I obviously love going out finding the pieces. That's like the best part. But it's also really fun to sort of teach yourself like how to build your website, which is what I've done. I've built that my website all on my own. I use Shopify to host it because from my research, it's the best. They won't charge you if you get loads of traffic. It's like they're very supportive, answering any questions you might have. You can get loads of really good free themes. And it's really easy to do yourself. I have no experience of making websites prior to starting my own one, and it has progressed as the time's gone on. I actually bought, like, you can buy themes if you want to, so I bought one, I think it was £150, but that was a few years ago now, but they keep updating it, so you can update it, and it's like really money well spent there, because you can have like drop down menus, which is good if you sell a lot of different items like I do. So you could have like blog, shop. I'm trying to think what's on my website now. And then like in the shop we drop down to like dresses, jackets, coats, and it's just like makes it a lot easier, and it's what you would kind of expect from a website, obviously. What else have I learned? You also become very adept at learning how to ship all sorts of items. iPost parcels are great for anything really heavy over 2 kg, going international. It's the best one I found. They come and collect it from your house. Very reliable. They do have a slightly bit of a bad reputation, but I have actually, touch wood, never had any issues with them, so I would recommend using them if you've got something heavy to send out. But I really think like the main things I have learned is that what I class as a hobby, which is now probably classed as like a side hustle, is it's a real passion for me. Like, I literally cannot tell you how much I love it. I do it all day, all night, and I would do it all weekend if I could, but I suppose I have to give Anthony a little bit of attention, don't I? and like see friends and family every now and again. But it's just, I just love it, and like you will learn so much without even really realising. Like, you'll learn about fabrics just from touching them, you'll be able to spot a quality item, and I really do feel like the best way to start your own vintage shop is just invest like a small amount of money. Like, I think overall in total I probably spent about £50 before I sold anything, but I did it gradually over probably about a month, so it's not like you wouldn't even notice it if it didn't work, you've not gone too deep. But what I really would recommend is like go down your local high street charity shop, wherever you are, thrift store if it's America, and just go and see what you can find, and then set yourself up on eBay, Etsy, whatever you feel comfortable selling on, and just start listing items, because you, even from your first item you will learn something. You can practice your photos, your photography skills will get better as they go on. I am the model, I use that word very very loosely, what I try to say. And the photographer, I do it all myself, so I bought myself a tripod all off eBay. I think it was like £15. I don't have a very expensive camera in terms of camera costs these days. It was like £350, and I bought that 5 years ago. It's a Sony, any something, I'm trying to look at it now, but I can't see it from here, but I'll list it below. It's nothing like mega fancy. It has like a 10-second timer on it. So I put my like iPhone backdrop, again from eBay, that cost me £25. And then like I've got some like really wide wallpaper, so it's like commercial wallpaper, so it's 1.5 meters wide. That was from my old job, so that was a freebie. But if you obviously don't have access to that, I would recommend just like going on eBay. You can buy like rolls of backdrop, so it's, again, it's really cheap. So it's not like a lot of money to, like, if you want like to do photos like me, it's not a lot of money to invest into that sort of setup. And also I don't have a lot of space in my house, so with all the stuff that I, like all my stock being here as well, and Anthony has no idea how much I have, it's really, like, space was like a prime issue for me. So you can all collapse it down, roll it up, and it's gone out of your way. It's not a lot to store, it doesn't get in the way, it's just in my utility. So that was good. But yeah, just start. Just have fun. I only buy what I like. And my rule has always been quality over quantity. And I think that has paid off, because if you sell a quality product, people will come back to you and you offer quality service, they're going to come back to you, aren't they? So they are my top tips. And just to recap, because I do ramble, don't I? Is invest a small amount of money. And as soon as you start buying your first items, don't wait to have loads, just list them straight away. I like to sort of do outfits so you can sort of say, oh, like a vintage biker jacket with like a vintage floral place that you, and then I have noticed now that my customers like to buy like a whole outfit as you're sort of sort of like outfit building for them, selling them sort of like a look like you would do like in high street stores or you see in fashion magazines. So I like to do that, and I have a styling background as well, so that's just fun for me. if you want to take your photos yourself, which means you can do it sort of in your own time, you don't have to wait for anyone, I'd invest in like a tripod. If you want to do more natural backgrounds, the world is your oyster, or get like an A-frame and then off you go. And have fun, buy what you like, and you really will be amazed at how much you will learn in a short space of time. Everything is on Google, it is your friend. One of my favourite websites is vintagefashionguild.org, and they are a wealth of information for like to check like labels of designers. They've got images and like all these other designers that you will find and you haven't heard of will all be on there, and you'll get to learn so much from that website. It's all free. Yeah, they're my top tips. So I really hope you have found this useful if you are considering starting your own vintage shop or any sort of online shop. My plans for the future are to take Ada's as far as I can take her. I literally love doing it so much. I'm also really seriously considering getting like a showroom, come like office space in my hometown Birmingham, because I really would love to meet you all in face to face, and it would be like an arrangement, sort of book your own open like appointment, can't speak, there's nothing new there, is an appointment, so you can come in and like I'll make sure you have everything there you like, and we can get to chat, maybe have a gin, coffee, depending on the time. So yeah, that'd be great. That's my plans for the next few years. Well, next year. I was gonna take me a few years. But thank you so much for watching me. I really, really, really blows my mind that you wanna watch me talk about something that I love. I love it so much. And thank you so much for requesting this video as well. It's been an amazing feeling to get a request. So I hope you all have an amazing week, and I shall see you very soon. Bye.